saw, I remember going to Grandma's house growing up and seeing his room with the blinds closed and his TV running on the sports channel. And he would sit on the end of his bed just watching WWF wrestling, choosing which team we were on, The Rock, Stone Cold, Steve Austin. We could pull up the WWFers probably more than we should have been able to. But Scott was there and was present with us growing up and didn't understand fully what he was battling at the time, but remember all of the positive moments with him and those times watching sports, watching wrestling, being out in the backyard with the geese, feeding the geese, looking at the weeping willow, and then of course hearing about all of his stories of their childhood. They normally were blaming my dad for throwing his truck in the pond, having to have them go wait out and get it. He talked about getting pulled over and sharing his life lessons with Emily and I. We heard a lot about his animals, his dog Duke, and just understood where his love of animals came from and how much he loved Lacey and Charlie and Love Point of the Humane Society and just really shared that love of animals with all of our family. Oh gosh, and in the later years we saw the darker side of Scott's mental illness and saw him struggling, and it made us, I think, more empathetic people, more understanding people in both of our work and in our lives. And we just are so grateful for Scott and all that he taught us and how much he loved us and how much we cared about him. That's for all of us. Oh, Jesus.
I'm not a talker, so I'll let Jenna go, but I will add that Scott was really, really easy to love. Really easy. I think I told him I loved him before. I say it to Jenna, we didn't say it growing up, but I remember on the phone, we talked to him all the time with my dad, and he'd say, "Hi, Scott." And I remember saying, like really at a young age, and it was weird because we didn't say it, but every day on the phone, "Scott, I love you, Scott," and it was just easy to say to him, and he needed it, and he loved us back, and sorry to all the other family members here, but I'd always say, "You're my favorite, Scott, you're my favorite, you're my favorite," and it took him a while to believe it, but he did, and he knew he was really loved, and I know, you know, I love you, Scott, I know, you know, just because he did. So, yeah, we just are going to miss him a lot. So, like I said, it wasn't always easy to be around, but he was really easy to love and was a really good person. We tell him all the time, "Scott, you have the biggest heart. You have the biggest heart of everybody." And so, yeah, I think we miss him a lot. So.